And so, as God's people, we have gathered.
Let us worship him together.
Be with us, Spirit of God.
Nothing can separate us from your love.
Breathe on us, breath of God.
Fill us with your saving power.
Speak in us, wisdom of God.
Bring us strength, healing, and peace.
And so we sing now our first hymn, which is Fight the Good Fight. As we're encouraged to turn to Christ, to lay hold of life, to lift up our eyes and seek God's face. We recognise that sometimes that we haven't turned back to God. And so in our prayer of penitence today, we renew our commitment to follow Christ. Lord, forgive us that sometimes we forget to seek your face. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, forgive us that sometimes we forget to trust you. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, forgive us that sometimes we fear and doubt. Lord, have
mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Now hear God's words of forgiveness. May the Father forgive you by the death of his Son and strengthen you to live in the power of the Spirit all your days. Amen. Almighty God, you search us and know us. May we rely on you in strength and rest on you in weakness, now and in all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now we have three short Bible readings, and the Rule family are going to bring those to us. Thank you very much.
First reading is from Jeremiah 27:11-14. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Plans for your welfare, not for harm, to give you a future with hope. Then when you call upon me and come and pray to me, I will hear you. When you search for me, you will find me. If you seek me with all your heart, I will let you find me, says the Lord. And I will restore your fortunes and gather you from all nations and all places where I have driven you, says the Lord. And I will bring you back to the place in which I sent you into exile.
1 Peter chapter 5, verses 6 to 11. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you. Discipline yourselves, keep alert like a roaring lion. Your adversary and the devil prowls around, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, steadfast in your faith, for you know that your brothers and sisters in all the world are undergoing the same kinds of suffering. And after you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, support, strengthen and establish you. To him be the power for ever and ever. Amen. Romans chapter 5, verses 1 to 5. Therefore, since we are justified by faith, we have peace with our God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand, and we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God. Not only that, but we boast in our sufferings, knowing that our sufferings produce endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope. And hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us.
Thank you very much, Annabelle. Well done. And I'm going to hand over now to Fenella. Thank you.
Hello. can everyone hear me?
Yes.
So I first wanted to introduce myself because I realised that there's a few people that might not know me. My name's Fenella, and I've been going to St Paul since I was little, but I've moved away from Egham Hythe, and I'm also at university, so I've not been able to come to the St Paul's services. And one beautiful thing about lockdown for me was that I was able to come back to St Paul's. And Rosie asked me if I would share like a bit about my faith journey. And I think a bit about my journey is one of persevering with God through difficult times, which is a theme that's been on my mind quite a bit recently, obviously, because of all the challenges we're facing. From the passages that were read, we're told we will face sufferings for a little while. And for me, there was a point where I faced quite a few trials in my life. Everything seemed a bit out of my control, and it seemed like everything was going wrong, and I was just not in a good place. And it left me doubting God and left me questioning who he was. God says he loves us with an everlasting love, and I did not feel that. I felt quite alone. And it came to the point where I felt I had to make a choice as to whether I would follow God. I either wanted to decide to choose him or to choose or face perhaps a darker path. And my decision wasn't like a spectacular miracle. It was just quite simple. And the result was I decided to trust in him and to choose him. I decided that I did believe, and I couldn't imagine my life without him. And I didn't want to give up on that relationship that I had with God. God tells us of these plans that he has for us. So I prayed to him and I said, Lord, I'm not really sure why my life is like this at the moment, but I asked him to show me that plan that he had for me, and to give me the strength to persevere through those difficulties so I could see what that plan was. I handed over those burdens to him to try and release some of that anger and pain, So mainly I could enjoy the happiness I did have in my life. After this trial, I can see where I'm personally better for going through it. I can see where I've suffered and I've been restored and made stronger. I can see what that plan was for me now, even though I couldn't possibly see it then. And the plan can mean so many things for everyone. And for me, that shows, the plan shows personal development and strength. And it also shows God's better plan for me than the one I had for myself. In some ways, for me, the trial still goes on. And I don't know what the future holds. But these passages from the readings are really important for me to remember to hold on to God and to persevere with him through these difficult times, to have hope for what is to come and wait for his plan to unravel. So lastly from me, I've prepared a song for reflection called Even When It Hurts. And aside from it being a really beautiful song, I think that it addresses quite clearly what I'm trying to say, that even when it's so difficult, especially at the moment in times like this, that we must try to still have God in our lives, to choose him and his love, and to persevere for the beauty that will come both on this earth and elsewhere. Thank you.
Take this fainted heart, take these tainted hands, wash me in your love, come like grace again. Even when my strength is lost, I'll praise you. Even when I have no song, I will praise you. Even when it's hard to find the words louder than I'll sing your praise. Ooh, I will only sing praise. Oh, I will only sing your praise. Take this mountain weight, take these ocean tears, hold me through the trial. Even when the fight seems lost, I'll praise you. Even when it hurts like hell, I'll praise you. Even when it makes no sense to sing louder, then I'll sing your praise. Ooh, I will only sing praise. I will only sing your praise. Ah, I will only sing your praise. And my heart burns only for you. You are all, you are all. My soul waits only for you, and I will sing till the morning has come. Lord, my heart burns.
Fenella, thank you so much. Thank you for your words and such beautiful, you've got such a beautiful voice and it's such a beautiful piece of music. We're going to declare our faith in God. We come to do that as we remember those difficult times when sometimes it's hard to choose to follow Christ. It's hard to choose to stay with him, that we have to remember to do that. So as we declare our faith and trust in God, however we're feeling together, whether it's hard or whether we're burning with fire for God, together we declare that faith and trust in him. We believe and in God the Father, from whom
every family
in heaven and on earth is named. We believe
God the Son,
who lives
in our hearts through faith
and fills us
with his love.
We believe
in God and the Holy Spirit,
who strengthens
us
in our hearts.
We believe
in one God,
Father,
Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
And now Nikki's going to lead our intercessions for us. Thank you, Nikki.
Responses today will be God of peace. Hear our prayer. O Lord our God, source of all goodness and love, accept the prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Lord, we pray for our children and young people as they start school, college, and university. We pray for wisdom, grace, and peace for the staff and students as they move into all the new challenges that school now means since lockdown. We pray for protection for those who are vulnerable, and we pray for parents and carers too, for wisdom and grace as they support the children and young people that we care for. Lord, we pray for all countries affected by coronavirus and those seeing an increase in cases again. Please give the political leaders and those making decisions wisdom as they decide what to do next. We continue to pray for a vaccine and for those scientists and doctors working in this area. Lord, you have taught us that the world is yours and those who dwell on it. Hear us as we pray for the life of the world, that every nation may seek the way that leads to peace, that human rights and freedom may everywhere be respected, and that the earth's resources may be shared between all people. God of peace, hear our prayer. We pray for the church community and for church Three Ways at St Paul's. We thank you for Holiday at Home and for the time to share at Home PAX as well. We pray that you will lead us in the next steps going forwards this autumn, and that we will continue to be a blessing within our community and also within the local schools now that they have reopened. We pray for the couples who have recently got married. And we lift all members of the church family at St Paul's to you. We ask that you help us to find ways of praying minute by minute in all that we find ourselves doing. We pray for the church leaders within our diocese and nationally, that they will be blessed with your wisdom as they make decisions and guide us forwards. God of peace, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for the community of Egham Hythe, specifically for those living in Huntingfield Way, Hythefield Avenue and Hythe Park Road. We raise each and every household within our community to you, and we ask that you will pour your love and peace on each person today, that they will feel you draw close to them, whatever they are feeling. We also pray for those who live or feel alone, that you will draw close to them this week and bring them comfort. God of peace, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, who in the days of your life here on earth showed compassion to the sick and afflicted and made them whole, bless those who are carrying on your healing work in our hospitals and nursing homes. Give them sympathy and skill and an ever-deepening understanding of their task, that in your mercy those who suffer in body or mind may be restored to full health. We include today in our prayers Edna, Laura, Marilyn, Stanford, Mabel, Sue, Trevor, Bill, Anne, Les, Joyce and Lucy. We pray for all those who are grieving and remember those who have died, including Vera Emmett, Christopher Court and Paul Fimbo, and at their year's mind, Edward Morris, Walter Blackwell and Dennis Mackinder. Living God, deliver us from a world without justice and a future without mercy. In your mercy, establish justice, and in your justice, remember the mercy revealed to us in Jesus Christ our Lord. We ask all these prayers in the name of Christ Jesus our Lord. God of peace, hear our prayer.
Hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
And we join our prayers together in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed
be thy name.
Thy kingdom
come,
thy will be done on earth
as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us
our trespasses,
as we forgive
those who trespass against us.
Lead us not
into temptation,
and
deliver us from evil.
For thine
is the kingdom,
the power,
and the glory,
forever and ever.
And ever.
Amen.
Amen.
We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace be with you. And now we're going to sing. Becky's not with us this morning. She's with Emily this weekend. And let's pray for them. And but she's going to be here on Zoom. See how we can do this. Mm-hmm. And we're going to sing Oceans Where Feet May Fall.
Thank you.
Hear God's blessing today. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you this day and evermore. Amen.